See, stop playing with a tripod. Guys, so. So, we finally got the last piece of the puzzle for Nationals. This was supposed to come on the 18th. It is currently the 21st, so we're cutting it a bit close since we leave on the 5th. And our last training session is the 3rd. So, the last piece of the puzzle is from Inner Strength Products, as usual. And SBD wrist wraps. So the reason that I got these in medium flexible because that is the most common, variant, I guess. It's the most common variant of the wrist wraps, and a lot of people said that the stiff ones were really stiff, and like, I don't want to get something so extreme like a couple weeks before. So I think these are going to be easier to get used to. I wanted to get the limited edition ones to match my knee sleeves that Caitlin gave me, but I couldn't get those because they were sold out at the time. And now they're restocked. They restocked them like yesterday or something like that, which is crazy. But you can already see that these are like really wide wrist wraps, like super wide, and they're really long. So the Inzer ones that I had for Provincials and Easterns, I really, really, really disliked because there wasn't a right and left specifically. There was just a left, basically. So with these SBDs, there is a right wrist wrap. And there is a left wrist wrap, which is how they should be made, right? There should be a right and a left. It just makes sense. I know you're not allowed to use the thumb hooks for competition, but like, God, like it makes it so much easier to get on. Like, but these feel wicked already. They're really, really, really like stiff. I've been using the Orso Strength ones that I've had for like a year, and they're starting to like, you know, break down after like a year of use. So like, it's common, but no, these are wicked. These are definitely gonna be my favorite wrist wraps. Say that. Like, I don't know if they're gonna be my favorite yet. But anyway, to put these on, it's super easy. All I have to do is go through the thumb loop and then wrap it around. I wrap my wrist wraps like so. So thumb loops right there. I think you're supposed to. Some people do it like, how do they do it? Some people do it like this. Thumb loop, and then they go around like this, like reverse way around. Well, not reverse, I guess this is normal for some people, but I just don't like going around like that. I don't know, I just don't find it, I don't like it. So what I will do is I'll put it on like this and go around this side of my hand first and get that nice tug right at the start. Wrist, and then wrap my wrist and my fist. And it's like a cast. The reason that I filmed my bench workout is because I thought these were gonna come in that day, so I was gonna have them for my last heavy sesh before Nats. But we have them now, so that's a plus.
Guys, it's been a little while. Today is Monday, what is today? Today is the 18th. So we're approximately 2 weeks on the nose out from CPU Nationals 2019. Super excited, super pumped. Today I've got a heavy bench workout, my last heavy bench workout before Nationals. So I'm gonna film it for you guys, take you through the whole thing. And yeah, it's pretty late. It's like 7:30. Me and Liam are headed to the gym now. So see you in the gym.
Hey man, isn't it so cringy that I have my camera out like this? Is there any need for it to be like this?
Quite cringy, bro.
Look at my display. Isn't that cringy?
Don't need.
Isn't that cringy?
It's quite cringy.
Quite.
All right, got 2:45 on the bar here, going for a single. This is probably going to be my last one, what was that, before 2:65? I didn't film my 1:35 or 2:25 because that's cringy, mate.
That's probably cringy.
Because my camera is dying like a dumbass. I forgot to charge my camera, but here comes 2:45 single. Having an okay bench session. We hit our 1:65 single and that felt good. Definitely moved at RP 10, maybe 9.5 if I'm lucky. So that's okay, at least we see where we are 2 weeks out. Plus the clips factored in, probably give us an extra couple pounds. Then we did 1:55 for 2x2 and it was
1:55, 1:65, that's what I heard.
We did 2:65 for a heavy single, and that moved okay, like I just said. And then we did 2:55 for a 2x2, and that moved at a RP 10. Like, that was like, could not squeeze another inch out of it, so. Yeah, then we just did our first board press, and it was big red light because my ass came off and the bar went back. I think I was just a bit nervous, so we're gonna nail down these last two singles for accessories. The bench press portion of our workout is done. And we've got some incline dumbbell rows, some incline dumbbell press, some face pulls to finish it off. Gym closes in like 20 something minutes, so we're gonna speed through this. No way.
And they were doing tests for creatine, which is actually weird because you'll actually have creatine in your body anyways without taking creatine.
Yeah, if you eat lots of red meats, isn't it? Then your body produces it.
The fish, tuna's really hot.
Fisk. Anyway, it's the last heavy bench day we're having before Nationals. Probably gonna cut the video here, edit her up tomorrow when I go in to hit some squats. Stay tuned, we're gonna do one more. No, edit it tomorrow.
When you're squatting?
Edit it tomorrow after I'm done squatting.
Okay.
Probably gonna film one more workout, more exercise, one more workout before Nationals, and then leave the rest up to the platform.